Hey, what do you think of the idea of a United Nations tax that Canadians and other people around the world have to pay? And the money wouldn't go to your local school or hospital. It would go to the United Nations itself. Does that sound like a crazy fantasy, really? Well, then you haven't heard from Claudia Rizet, journalist in residence at the Foundation for Defense of Democracies, who joins us from New York City. Hey, Claudia, welcome back to the show.
Hi, Ezra. Great to be here.
Now, this sounds like a science fiction, dark, futuristic movie where the UN taxes people directly and these unaccountable, unelected bureaucrats just run a world government. It sounds crazy, but it's actually being discussed by the UN right now, isn't it?
That's right. This is actually the current dark, appalling movie that has been taking place.
Well, tell me where this idea was talked about and what UN branch was hosting this discussion.
Okay. This idea of imposing global taxes for various things has been, the UN has been trying this and pondering it over and over for years, looking for some way to really get this rolling. And right now, it's the World Health Organization, which is talking about things like a tax on, a global tax on cigarettes. Now, beware. That all sounds very virtuous and so on. But the trouble with it is that it's one, it's an opening wedge where once the UN begins imposing a global tax, it means that your money will flow not to a government that you can hold to account, but to this enormous cross-border archipelago of agencies and offices and so on that is the United Nations. And you will now have, of course, what do they do with that kind of thing? If the record is any guide, they use some of those resources to dream up more schemes for taxing you, okay? So this is part of a process where once they get through that dam and set this precedent that they really, that they'll start imposing global taxes, you have the gates open for a carnival of corruption and attempted control over our lives like you have never seen.
Now, I mean, I'm in Canada and we have enormous sin taxes right now on booze, on cigarettes. They're talking about soft drink taxes now too. I mean, they're really coming for it. But at the end of the day, I guess at least the money stays here in Canada and it's spent by our elected parliamentarians. Are you saying that the proposal that the World Health Organization is putting forward, they would raise taxes in Canada, like they would collect taxes in Canada somehow, but instead of going to spending in Canada, that money would go to New York City and we'd never see it again?
Money would go to some place where the UN spends it. You know, New York City, UN offices around the world, however they decided to dispose of it. But your government would have to agree to this scheme. But once it does, you've got something in place where you're exactly right. The money just flows out. The UN does whatever it wants to with it. Remember, the UN is already really unaccountable. There have been scandal after scandal precisely for that reason. And you can't prosecute senior UN officials. You don't elect them. It is a collective of 193 member states, which has just did things like put Venezuela and Pakistan on the Human Rights Council. It's just elected Sudan to ECOSOC, one of the main bodies of the General Assembly. That's who decides how resources taken in by the UN get spent. And the fundamental principle here, Ezra, is you and your government have a contract, if you live in a democratic state, that you may not like everything that gets done, but they have to account to you for how they spend your money. And that would cut this bond, basically. It would just go to the UN. And again, the biggest harm is not simply wasted money and so on, it's that it would go to feed this growing, unaccountable, overreaching bureaucracy.
Right. You know, this sounds like them trying to do what they did with the Kyoto Protocol with carbon credits and all sorts of money-wringing things. Well, that failed. Well, this is the new thing. Now, this talk just, we only have about a minute left, but this went down in Seoul, Korea, am I right there, where the Framework Convention on Tobacco Control was meeting. Now, Canada is a part of that, but I understand that when they brought up the subject of a global tax, that it was closed to journalists and the public, and that they went in a secret meeting. Can that possibly be true, Claudia?
Oh, that's very much the way the UN functions on these things. It's part of the reason. It would be a terrible mistake to allow them any form of global tax. You know, you need some controlling mechanism. The only ones that are really there right now are that governments such as the United States or Canada try to hold them to account. And if they bypass that, you have an institution that has diplomatic immunity, is, by the way, failing to solve problems such as war. You know, look what's going on right now with the terrorist attacks on Israel out of Gaza. Yeah. And it's not doing well on that. It hasn't stopped the Iranian bomb or the North Korean nuclear bomb, but it does aspire at this point to collect your money and tell you how you should live your life. That should be a contract between you and the government of your sovereign country, not something that the UN dictates to whoever it can reach around the world.
Well, I'm really grateful to you to ring this alarm bell for us. Claudia Rosette from Foundation for Defense of Democracies. You keep fighting, okay?
Thank you, Ezra.
Thanks.